Acquire the Fire, 2007. All our peeps. The mountains of Libra. Aunt Melody. Made it to a youth event the first time in 12 years. Nice living rooms that we got here at the Embassy Suites. TV.
I only got 10 minutes.
This kid's worried about his hair getting done. Abraham's first time coming. Well, we got people everywhere. Oh, sorry, man. I didn't mean to get you on camera. You might not have wanted me.
We got this where the phones
are.
Show me your chest. Look at this guy. He comes to quiet fire and sits down and watches TV.
Can't you do it?
Get out of the way.
Observe.
Hit it. And go. 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 Get it. Get it. Get it. What? Man, that's weak. Say a little something into the camera.
I gotta poop.
Oh, a little something into the camera.
I do.
These are all the kids that are going to quite a fight this year. And they're all up in the hotel. Dancing in the elevators. What a nice place we got here. It's our big dog Abel. Say a little something.
How you guys doing? Well, this is Battle Cry, hotel room. This is my crib. Why don't you come on in? No.
this is where I like to sit down, yeah. You know.
That's my little dinette set. It costs about 15 G's right there. Get a load of that, you know.
That's his housekeepers.
Those are my housekeepers. I probably got in from Mexico.
Look at that table there.
He's got his hot pepper with
pepper bellies.
That's a pepper belly.
He's not doing too good of a job. Look at that table. I messed up.
Look, she's trying to straighten up, but look, it ain't working. She left all the other empties there.
How you doing, man?
Doing my job.
About 1 o'clock in the morning.
Let me duck to the video camera real quick. I just want to let the video camera know that I forgot my pajamas. So, see y'all. We'll see who's sleeping in the same bed.
I already put Brandon's shoe there. Told him he better keep his hands to himself.
Hey.
Dude, let's see that. Let's see the replay.
You didn't see him with Nick last year, so I seen some stuff I don't ever want to see.
Look, say something.
No.
Little girl scared of the camera. Running like a woman.
rumors. That was last year.
Rumors. That was last year. Oh, you're past that stage. Huh?
That was my adolescence, or my beginning.
Save me some eggs! Some sausage!
Oops. No. This is the breakfast line, the morning. All the way down there. Hey,
what?
Did you get your
I'm
growing up, he had the perfect family. You know, his mom and dad loved him. And everything down within them. And his dad was his best friend. His dad was his hero. His dad was his role model. And as this kid was getting older, his dad would take him fishing and camping every summer. Take him to his favorite baseball game. And unexpectedly, one morning, this kid woke up and his dad was gone from his life forever. His dad said he had enough and just abandoned him and his mom and his sister and left them all behind. And this kid was so hurt what his dad had done that over the years, this man that was once his kid's best friend was now his worst enemy. This kid wanted nothing to do with his dad at all. He hated his dad and everything he had within him. And unfortunately, that's the case for a lot of people. And maybe you're one of the people today that maybe you grew up with a dad that loved you and he just took off and left you behind. And you've had nothing to do with your dad since that day and you've never wanted to talk to him. I'm here to tell you guys tonight that there's a God that loves each and every one of us so very much. And that he can fill that void, you know, that person that once we trusted, that we now hate. That's not what Jesus tells us to do, you know what I'm saying? Jesus tells us that the people who treat us wrong, the people that hurt us the most, even though it's easy for us to hate them, the thing that Jesus wants us to do is to love those people with everything that he's done for us, you know what I'm saying? So I want to see every cell phone up in the air as we play this next song for you. It's called Everything You Ever Wanted.
Change us.